Jello Beats, holla at me.
Yeah, so go through the report. So you see your DEXA image. Yellow is body fat, mm-hmm. not much on there. Red is your lean tissue, so focusing on your muscle mass. And blue is bone.
Okay.
So for the scan, we break the body down into different regions. So measure each arm, each leg, and your trunk. Your trunk is this main upper body mass here.
Okay.
So with DEXA, we ignore your head. When we're looking at body composition. So read down to this line here, and see in total you are carrying 6.6 kilos of fat.
Okay.
So obviously not a lot. I mean, if you take into account things like essential fat and that.
How much essential fat is like?
It's gonna be standard. For a guy probably averaging 3 to 5%.
Okay. Of total body weight.
In total body weight, yeah, absolutely, okay. Now, we also measure your android and your gyno regions.
Okay.
Your android region is this small rectangle through the belly.
Right.
So that's where we expect men to store their highest proportions of body fat. And gynoid is this bigger rectangle. That's where we expect females to store their highest.
Interesting. So it looks like I almost store more in my female area.
In terms of grams, you will,
because
it's a bigger area. But in terms of percentage, well, percentage a little bit higher than android, but it's pretty similar. But that's pretty low in terms of gyno fat, because that's covering the bottom part of your glutes. So to be at 10.9 means you're going to be pretty lean in that area.
Yeah, it means it hurts to sit down and
that. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So DEXA will measure your fat mass in grams in each area. It will measure your lean and your bone mass in grams in each area. Those two will be separated on the middle page, and then your total mass is the two columns added together.
Okay.
Then have your percentage fat in each area. So you're seeing total 10.3.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then your distribution. Interestingly, your arms actually come up as your highest percentage.
Really weird. Yeah, I wouldn't have ever expected that.
Yeah.
If anything, I'd expected my left leg, right leg. To be the areas that hold, but
yeah, the legs are pretty lean. In terms the trunk 9.2, super lean, as I said, the lowest we've had in.
Weird about the arms. That's weird, but there we go. Potentially some more to come off the arms.
How long have you got to next year?
Got 2.5 weeks.
Okay.
So the goal is to be a little tighter.
Yeah.
But again, like we were discussing earlier, the balance between the two, I had a really good look at the finals. It was like a good look, and there was a lot of people that were like, don't get any leaner than you are now.
Yeah.
And focus on just staying full.
Yeah.
So if I can get another, because you know how much difference it makes when you're lean, if I can get another like half a pound to a pound off,
yeah,
I'm pretty happy with that.
Yeah, of course.
See if we can get it off the left and the right arm.
Yeah.
But yeah, like for me in pictures and where I've seen, like the only areas that I'm holding a little bit, could come off a little bit more, would be hamstrings from the rear and glutes from the rear. My glutes are diced from the side.
Yeah.
My downside of my quads and sort of like the outside of my quads. Quads are peeled, like there's not much to come off them. Upper body's like pretty in all areas. it's just those last little bits. If
it's,
I really want to,
like,
areas,
though, isn't
yeah,
it?
I mean, it's like, do you really want striated glutes for the cost of potentially not having body parts popping anymore?
Yeah,
like,
sure.
It's, you don't win shows based on just having a shredded ass.
Yeah, of course.
In fact, the guy that came third at the BNBF finals in the juniors was, he probably had the most striated glutes on stage.
Yeah, of course.
Probably one of the leanest in the entire show.
Yeah.
And I knew he had that, but he had other body parts that weren't up to the standard.
Yeah,
or the
of course.
Muscularity
yeah.
took over. So
well, it's bodybuilding.
Yeah, yeah, it's bodybuilding. It's not competitive dieting.
Yeah.
Cool.
Exactly. Right. Other numbers to look at. So you have your two indexes. You have your how much fat you carry for your height.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah.
Fat mass index.
So this is what
your
people use
lean mass index.
Sometimes determine who's natty or not, right?
Yeah, so 19.4, be no queries of your natural status.
Wicked, good.
Yeah. 25 is sort of the upper
echelons.
Threshold
yeah.
for natural athletes.
Okay. And do you remember what Jordan Peters' fat free mass index was?
His was 33.
30.
So I'd say you'd probably have to gain, you're looking at 14 points, and usually a point is about 3 kilos of muscle, so you have to pack 42 kilos of muscle on your 5'8 and a bit frame
to catch
Jordan. That's always a
okay.
target to aim for.
Yes, I think that'd take a few years or an off-season.
A few extra carbs.
Yeah.
5 grams of creatine a day.
Yeah, that's probably what would take me there.
Yeah. Your fat mass index is just super low.
Okay.
It's the lowest I've seen from a competitor.
Oh,
so 2.58, not even on the charts. Very, very low levels of body fat.
Mm.
Okay.
And if I took this to my GP, what would they say? Would they say immediately gain some body fat?
You took it to GP, they probably wouldn't even know what this was. Useless, aren't they? No, honestly, they wouldn't, because this is a private service.
Ah, okay.
So GPs, if you said, oh, I've got a DEXA scan, they would just assume it was for bone density, because that's the clinical use for it. But obviously, privately is the best way to measure fat and muscle as well.
The interesting thing is that I'm still in like the normal BMI.
Yeah.
Because obviously in a gaining phase, in a mass gaining phase, I'll be like in the overweight or obese categories.
Yeah, be joining the fat weight club.
Yeah, because I'm so light, I guess.
Yeah.
It puts me in that bracket. BMI is a bit of a... Well, it's a complete waste of time.
Yeah, exactly.
Cool.
Yeah. Other numbers to look at, so measure your levels of internal fat, okay, your visceral fat.
Right.
So VAT, visceral adipose tissue, okay. Quite made it onto the chart. It's the level of internal fat. So it's the fat linked to things like diabetes, heart disease, stroke, colon cancer. It's the internal fat surrounding the organs. Obviously, you want to be carrying as low a level as possible there. 24.5 instead.
So from a health perspective, is it actually quite healthy to have low visceral body fat?
Yeah. You know, that's not essential fat.
Yeah.
It's the more dangerous fat, so that's obviously good for you.
Sure.
Good. So those are the numbers you can pick up on the first page. The middle page will show you if you have any obvious muscle imbalances.
Oh, okay, interesting. Right.
So you've seen your lean tissue. A bit more on the right arm, but
pretty
similar. Again, on the legs, slightly right dominant, but pretty similar.
Pretty similar, that's good.
In terms of your muscle distribution, you carry just under 3.6 in your arms, 26.8 in your trunk, and 10.6 in your legs. So you haven't been skipping leg there.
No, my legs have always been a strong body part.
Legs come up as your highest area of muscle mass.
Okay.
Your torso comes up as your lowest.
Okay, interesting.
So that's muscles in your chest, back and core.
Yeah.
Your arms are kind of in between the two.
Interesting.
That
yeah.
kind of.
Yeah, it makes sense. So, although I'd say probably my arms are weaker than my back.
Yeah.
But so my chest and my delts are. Well, my chest and my core probably lagging in terms of.
Yeah.
Body parts, but my back's probably one of my strongest body parts. So.
Yeah.
But yeah, I agree with the legs side of things in terms of having the most muscle there.
Yeah, the arms. Arms will take into account your shoulders as well.
Delts, yeah, okay.
Yeah, so arms and shoulders kind of come up in between the two.
Yeah.
Okay. Final page. Not too interesting. This is just your bone density.
All right.
People who do resistance training always have regular bone density. Yours is 10% above where we expect it to be for your age.
Great.
So it just means you're less likely to have a fracture or a break.
Nice, yeah.
No issues there.
Good.
It'll only go up the more sort of resistance training you do.
Okay. Cool.
That is your.
That is it.
That's your
run through. Wicked. Cool.